You'd be surprised how much you'd miss Dunlop.
What?
Dunlop tennis balls. Dunlop inflatable boats. Dunlop slippers.
Dunlop was a British multinational company involved in the manufacture of various natural rubber goods. The company was founded by Harvey Du Cros and John Boyd Dunlop in 1889 as Pneumatic Tire and Booth Cycle Agency Company, and then was changed to Dunlop Pneumatic Tire in 1895, and then was changed to Dunlop Rubber Company in 1901, and then was changed to Dunlop in 1967. But unfortunately, they were acquired by BTR PLC in 1985, becoming a brand that, which was then operated by different companies worldwide after BTR folded. So, what happened? How was it game over for Dunlop? Well, let's find out. Early history. In 1888, John Boyd Dunlop, a Scottish veterinarian surgeon living in Ireland, discovered the pneumatic tire principle. Willie Hume curated publicity for J.B. Dunlop's discovery by winning 7 out of 8 races with his pneumatic tires. To own the rights and exploit the discovery, the Pneumatic Tire and Booth Cycle Agency Company was incorporated in 1889 and floated by Harvey Du Cros, who was amongst other things, president of the Irish Cyclists Association. The invitation to Du Cros to participate was made by William Bowden, a Dublin cycle agent. J.B. Dunlop, who could see no prosperous future in his discovery, had informally made over his rights to Bowden. Initially, J.B. Dunlop held a 20% stake in the venture. The company and manufactory was first founded in Stephens Street in Dublin. Pneumatic Tire. The late 1880s was a period of great demand for John Kemp Starley's new safety bicycles. Pneumatic Tire began cycle tire production in Belfast in late 1890 and quickly expanded to fill consumer demand. However, in 1890, J.B. Dunlop's patent was withdrawn. It had been discovered that Robert William Thompson had first patented the pneumatic tire in 1845. J.B. Dunlop and Harvey Du Cros together worked through the ensuing considerable difficulties. They employed inventor Charles Kingston Welch, and also acquired other rights and patents which allowed them to protect their business's position to some extent. Tire established divisions in Europe and North America, sending their 4 of Du Cros's 6 sons. Factories were established overseas because foreign patents rights would only be maintained if the company was engaged in active manufacture where its tires were sold. Pneumatic Tire partnered with local cycle firms such as Clement Cycles in France and Aldridge in Germany in order to limit the necessary capital expenditure. An American business was established in the USA in 1893 with a factory in Buffalo, New York, after Harvey Du Cros Jr. was old enough to sign the necessary needs. In 1893, home manufacturer was relocated from Belfast to Dublin in Coventry, the center of the British cycle industry. The Dublin Corporation had launched a case against Pneumatic Tire, claiming nuisance from the smell of rubber and naphtha. Pneumatic Tire soon spread developing interests in Birmingham. The following year, a major interest was taken in their component supplier, Brine Bros India Rubber of Litchfield Road, Aston, Birmingham. The same year, Du Cros started cycle components manufacturing in Selly Oak to supply inner tubes. Dunlop Pneumatic Tire. J.B. Dunlop resigned in 1895 and sold most of his interest in Pneumatic Tire. In 1896, Harvey Du Cros persuaded his board to sell Pneumatic Tire to financier Ernest Taro Hooley for £3 million. Hooley drummed up support by offering financial journalists cheap shares and appointing aristocrats to the board, and quickly sold the business again, this time as the Dunlop Pneumatic Tire Company, for £5 million, providing a gross profit to Hooli Syndicate, including Ducros, of £1.7 million. Associate and supplier Byron Bros India Rubber at their Manor Rubber Mills, Aston Cros, had moved from making tire and tube components to complete inner tubes and covers. In June 1896, Ducros formed a new company, Rubber Tire Manufacturing, to acquire Byron Bros, e.g. Byron was contracted to be managing director for 5 years. Dunlop Rubber. From the late 1890s, Dunlop Pneumatic Tire began to acquire its own rubber mills and began to process rubber, whereas previously it had assembled tires using components from other manufacturers. In 1901, Dunlop Pneumatic Tire used its majority holding to rename Rubber Tire Manufacturing to Dunlop Rubber. Arthur Ducros replaced E.J. Byron. From 1900, Dunlop began to diversify from cycle tires. The company manufactured its first motor car tire in 1900. In 1906, a car wheel manufacturing plant was built. In 1910, Dunlop developed its first aeroplane tire and golf ball. Between 1904 and 1909, the French Dunlop subsidiary lost a total of £200,000, as European rivals such as Michelin of France and Continental of Germany overtook it in the motor tire market. In 1909, Dunlop of France, and in 1910, Dunlop of Germany were wholly acquired by the British parent in order to enforce stronger quality control. Amalgamation of Dunlop Pneumatic Tire and Dunlop Rubber. In August 1912, Dunlop Pneumatic Tire went out of business through retaining certain financial commitments. It passed its activities to Dunlop Rubber in exchange for shares. Then it changed its name to the Parent Tire Company Limited. Dunlop Rubber purchased certain of its assets, including goodwill and trading rights, and in exchange, the tire company shareholders now own 3/4 of Dunlop Rubber. The amalgamation was intended to bring about a substantial reduction in overhead and clarify what had been seen as a confusing relationship between the two enterprises when they shared most shareholders. Arthur Ducros was made managing director and deputy chairman in 1912 and retained that position after his father's death in 1918, when A.L. Ormard became chairman through until 1921. For supply, Ducros selected estates in Ceylon and Malaya for purchase, and by 1917, the company owned about 60,000 acres of rubber plantations. In 1916, construction began on the Fort Dunlap site across 400 acres. By 1918, Dunlap was the 14th largest manufacturing company in Britain, and its only large-scale tire manufacturer. Arthur Ducros became personally close to the financier, James White, and appointed him as Dunlop's financial advisor in 1913. By 1919, White had acquired control of the company. White speculated on the rubber futures market with disastrous results when the price of rubber collapsed. Meanwhile, there were also quality control problems with the tires. This came to a head in August 1921 when the company announced a loss of £8 million on the year's trading. The company was saved by the intervention of Frederick Savarshi of the British Foreign and Colonial Corporation. White's board member nominees were removed, and Sir Eric Geddes was appointed as chairman. And there's the history of Dunlap. So what went wrong with Dunlap? Well, I'd have to say that the problems began in the 1900s, where there were problems with the tires that they were manufacturing. And when tires have problems, things don't go too well because tires are a very important part of any sort of vehicle. And if there's a problem with the tire, then if there's any problem with any of the tires, things can go very well, and And if it's a problem that can't be fixed, then it's a really big problem, and the tires will need to be replaced with another tire. Anyway, that is where I'm going to end off today's video. If you guys haven't enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit that like button, and also don't forget to subscribe because I do videos every single day. And also don't forget to ring the notification bell so you never miss a single video that I upload. And also don't forget to subscribe and ring the notification bell on my second channel. My second channel will be the third link in the description below. And if you guys would like to send me fan art, you guys can send me fan art on my Instagram. My Instagram will be the second link in the description below. And if you guys would like to join, my Roblox fan group, my Roblox fan group will be the first link in the description below. And if you guys would like to follow me on Twitter, my Twitter will be the fourth link in the description below. And if you guys would like to follow me on Reddit, my Reddit will be the fifth link in the description below. And if you guys would like to follow me on TikTok, my TikTok will be the sixth link in the description below. And if you guys would like to check out my Facebook page will be the sixth link in the description below. And until then, I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!